Hello galactic family. My loves. It is assumed that none of the great observations of beings of light in the universe expected the liberation of Earth and its humanity to take so long. But the question also arises as to why the human spiritual masters of my higher truth have not especially emphasized the question of the ascension and the liberation of mankind. They even suggest that there is no ascension to all of humanity happening at the same time because it is primarily an individual process and event. They did not mention this in a particular way because each being is responsible for their own process of spiritual liberation according to their evolutionary journey and the state in which they participate in a cycle of incarnation. However, it is true that in times when a larger evolutionary process is uniquely supported, there are cosmic influences that make it easier for an individual to awaken and evolve, and that this can trigger an awakening of many because you, my humanity, is one being and the whole human family is interconnected with each other. So what only a single spiritually awakened being does, has a great effect on his human family in the first place, and secondly also on the networks of all earthly realms, especially on the earth itself. The moment all these prophecies are fulfilled, there will be a great liberation from humanity. From the point of view of separation, a human being who is in this concept considered as a separate entity, as the Christian Church considers Jesus to be a separate entity, and not surrender to my divine consciousness, whom Jesus called the Father. The process of releasing a seemingly separate being, who wishes to become like Jesus, as described by the Christian Church, and who is identified with the dream state, is necessarily relatively easy rather than that deep. But myself, the ultimate reality of existence, the source of all beings I have interceded, my beloved ones, for you to awaken from this dream. Its implications are enormous and you cannot imagine what it means in relation to a true and radical process of enlightened humanity in the whole universe that transcends the state of the dream. From time to time, the spiritual mastery of human beings has been described primarily in this dream state, with teachings that came to Earth from the ancient races of more evolved stars. But these teachings involve serious limitations, which you, my humanity, are capable of transcending because of your inheritance of pure irrevocable divinity. As long as you remain in your consciousness limited to the state of the dream, you are limited to a state which regards a separate body of light as the highest possible form of evolution. Myself, however, showed the way beyond. I show the way straight to my house, to the authentic source of your being, that which is my reality. Now consider this as it is the radical dissolution of illusions. The process of purification must go to the depth of existence itself. Therefore, this process includes the integration of consciousness on the other side of the frequency band, the so-called dark beings, their slaves and tyrants, controllers and abusers. In this radical process of liberation that I have initiated through my divine intervention, everything that exists in this universe and beyond must be accepted, integrated as a mirror of itself, and finally dissolved in my infinite consciousness of the divine source, which is yours true divine natural state, the origin of your being and existence itself, what you really are. This deep and radical process to which you have been invited goes far beyond your ascending cycles of spiritual traditions. It requires integration and transcendence not only of the totality of your human subconsciousness and also of universal consciousness but also of all the obvious appearances in your world, including those you oppose. And so, in this process of becoming truly conscious, and not just conscious in the state of the dream, you conclude that everything arises in my divine consciousness. And to integrate and transcend all this takes time, my beloved ones. It is not done in a single lifetime for the vast majority of you, and probably not even in your personal case. It includes the integration and transcendence of the duality that always exists as long as the universe is perceived and understood as another, in the sense of one I, to the detriment of another, to be perceived as friendly or hostile and everything in between. Note also that even the most ardent follower of the Master Jesus of Nazareth, and other masters love them as the other, be aware of this. But, finding liberation as that which I am, duality must be radically transcended to the point where subject and object disappear or merge into singularity. This happens through the transcendence of the mind. But not in the sense that the mind would cease to exist. But as my divine consciousness is revealed to you as your true identity, the paradoxical mind makes me in a way that you are just witnessing that it rises in me. This process necessarily requires that about 95% of your potential unconsciousness must become conscious. It is ALL that exists, and includes, of course, all apparent opposing forces, such as darkness and light, large and small, expanded and contracted, good and bad, and so on. All this must be recognized as self and not separate from me. Radical liberation requires the transcendence of all this to enter the state in which I am, where the subject and the object in its present understanding no longer exist, neither in this world nor in no other world. Above or below, brighter or more shady, it does not matter. Thus, as the task has become multidimensional, including the integration of all opposites into all worlds, the process of purification has become radical and deeper, since the most radical liberation process is set in motion by intervention, failing to allow the game in the state of the dream that suppresses its true divinity. And now, this is important. The situation on Earth as it is at this time is more conducive to this process. It is here that you are able to open your consciousness to learn to understand the nature of the apparent opposites and especially the light and the darkness. Therefore, this condition on your Earth serves to understand this unique universal paradigm, to learn about it and integrate it to expand consciousness, until it merges with my supreme divine consciousness, the knowledge of the supreme light and joy as substance of ALL appearances. Although the New Age teachings proclaim that the Earth is fundamentally a place for its amusement and that it has been interfered by the forces of darkness, the reality is that the Earth is a school for humanity to grow, exactly to deal with the darkness within the duality. You are not victims, beloved. If your Earth did not give you this unique learning opportunity, you would have to leave it and move to a place similar to what it is now. That is, you cannot really evolve after my divine intervention here, without learning the lesson of integration, to be released in my divine state of unlimited and eternal splendor/radiance. An ascended Earth in a dream state is therefore not conducive to beings who need to learn this special lesson. But the state of the Earth, as it stands now, supports the possibility of being released by me without ascending to higher dimensions of the dream state or existing for some time. In this sense, the Earth is not obliged to ascend to support its ultimate liberation, although it is a very evolved and loving being. By my grace, you can become free of all the dimensions and states of the dream if you are willing to integrate all your subconscious content and transcend it into my divine supreme consciousness of reality. It necessarily requires a difficult test in auto-purification and facing its oldest wounds to be healed and dissolved, once suppressed in the darkness of your own subconscious mind. It is a form of fire for the ego, and without it, liberation and conclusion in me, its true divine nature, is not possible. Although false New Age teachings are suggesting the easy course, arousing false and absurd hopes. The process in which the unconscious becomes conscious is the ancestral path of evolution and self-realization, and this form has not changed today. But he became unknown in this time of darkness and lost true teachings of wisdom. It cannot be done alone, because your separate ego cannot break free. You would be lost in the endless labyrinth of illusions of the mind, confusion and false perceptions. It is a serious process that goes deeper, deeper than you could go alone without a true master guide. Many have lost their way by their own unconsciousness. So now you still ask, why does your release take so long? It takes so long because you have not yet touched the bottom of the unconscious deeper within you as a universal being. In aspects of your life, you react to reflect exactly what has not yet been released within you. So far, you remain perhaps only on the surface of hope and childish belief, sentimentally connected to the anxious emotions to be free, not wanting to really come to terms with a radical descent into your own Hades to bring there, with my help, my truth, eternal light, and consciousness. Whatever you do to all your humanity. Your intrepid courage to be an authentic torch taken to everything and everyone. And then you must now ask yourself, what is your gift in this process and what gifts have you given to your brothers and sisters and the earth? This is the job. Do not ask anymore. Take responsibility for your process, which is the process within the whole. It is the most sacred and ultimate process of true liberation, in which being in a pleasant and easy space does not necessarily help. You may ask, why did I intervene? And why is such a profound process now being offered to you? Beloved, it was the desire of his own soul. You, mankind, has asked for that. And I answered. I am your divine self, the self of all beings, worlds and things. Message transmitted by Utpo Sigurdal.